In the wizarding world, we encounter so many fascinating spells.
Peraverto.
Some useful, some a little more dangerous, and some that show us just how beautiful and powerful magic can be. Today, we're thinking about the Patronus charm, a complicated and immense spell using hope and happiness to conjure a silvery animal which acts as a guardian to the caster. The Patronus charm is used to protect wizards and witches from the darkness of the wizarding world, most famously known for warding off the awful magical non-beings, the Dementors. But a Patronus, and the form it takes, also reveals a part of yourself through the vision of this majestic silver animal. But why? What makes a Patronus unique to the caster? In the Harry Potter stories, we discover several characters' Patronuses, with some forms revealing a deeper truth. J.K. Rowling defines the Patronus as representing that which is hidden in a person, an awakened secret self that lies dormant when needed. A Patronus appears to be able to reflect people's personalities, their desires, their family, or even a loved one. Famously, Harry has a stag that mirrors his late father's animagus form, and shows Harry that he and James Potter are deeply and eternally connected.
It was my dad who conjured the Patronus.
But Harry, your dad's...
dead, I know. I'm just telling you what I saw.
Patronuses can serve as manifestations in other ways too. Perhaps the most tragic example of this? It could only be Severus Snape's Patronus, which was the same as his long-lost love, Lily Potter.
Always.
We also know that a Patronus can change form, depending on someone's personal circumstances. For example, in the books, Nymphadora Tonks' Patronus changes from a jackrabbit to a wolf when she falls in love with Remus Lupin, a reference to Lupin's furry little problem. So if someone has an animal that is already personal to them, it seems this can also influence a Patronus's form. For example, a witch or wizard that also happens to be an animagus is likely to have a matching Patronus. For instance, Professor McGonagall can turn into a cat at will, and her Patronus, also a cat.
That was bloody brilliant!
This makes sense, as both McGonagall and our feline friends never suffer fools gladly. But some Patronuses are a little more abstract, and we can only make educated guesses on what they may mean. Take Hermione's Patronus, for example, an otter. But why an otter? With Hermione's great wisdom, you might have thought she'd have a dolphin or an owl.
I checked this out weeks ago for a bit of light reading.
This is light.
But otters are pretty canny too. They also happen to be J.K. Rowling's favourite animal. Not only that, but otters are known as adventurous and playful creatures. A side to Hermione that we get to see the more we get to know her.
Sort of exciting, isn't it? Breaking the rules.
And you could also interpret that an otter comes from the same family of mammals as the weasel. Weasel kind of sounds like something else.
Ron Weasley.
Pleasure.
Side note, Ron's dad, Arthur Weasley, actually has a weasel for his Patronus. Weasels tend to be very cunning animals, and although you may not think of Arthur Weasley to be sneaky, he did have his moments.
Your sons flew that enchanted car of yours to Surrey and back last night.
Did you really? How'd it go?
This brings us on nicely to Ron's Patronus, a Jack Russell Terrier. A bit of a random choice. But on closer inspection, this is quintessentially Ron. First and foremost, a dog is known as a loyal companion, one of Ron's greatest attributes. Then there's a Jack Russell specifically, a dog known to be fearless.
I'll be a knight.
But also pretty stubborn.
Let's vote on it. Those in favour?
Luna Lovegood also has a beloved furry creature as a Patronus, a friendly hare. Yes, regrettably, not a nargle. Luna's eccentric personality fits a hare quite well. Firstly, there's the phrase, as mad as a march hare, which some people may perhaps say is fitting for Luna.
Everyone, this is Luna Love... Luna Lovegood.
But it goes a little deeper than that. Hares are often referenced in folklore to be associated with the moon. Luna's name in Latin also means moon.
That's nice.
And remember how we told you Tonks' original Patronus was a jackrabbit? A jackrabbit is also a form of a hare, and her future husband Remus's connection to the moon is clear. Coincidence? But sometimes a person's Patronus really isn't that complicated. Can you take a wild guess at what Dolores Umbridge's might be, for example? No further explanation required. But for someone a bit more complex, a Patronus can be a fascinating extension to them. Professor Dumbledore, for example, has a magical creature as a Patronus, a phoenix, just like his friend Fawkes. This makes absolute perfect sense, with Dumbledore and his family being intrinsically linked to this magical bird for many years. Dumbledore even named the secret society he founded the Order of the Phoenix. And with Dumbledore being so generally amazing, we're not surprised in the slightest that he has such a fantastic beast for a Patronus. So, as we've learnt, a Patronus can sometimes seem like a logical interpretation of your character, or on other occasions, can teach you something about your inner self that you might never have known. So how about you? On wizardingworld.com, you can take our Patronus experience and discover your own silvery animal guardian. We have over 100 creatures, with some rarer than others, you could discover by answering a few simple prompts. Our most popular Patronus is a dolphin, which is a good sign. Dolphins are notoriously friendly, intelligent, and elegant mammals, so we're heartened that so many of you discovered that one. But like Dumbledore, you too could find a more magical creature in our collection, from unicorns to fiery dragons. So why not log in to wizardingworld.com and discover yours today? Just remember to think of a happy thought.